Ooh, I love a big old pile of goodness. Look at all this treasure in front of us. We're going to do a pick today. You've been ghosted. This is the Witchy Fall section. This is not Witchy Fall, but I love that trinket dish. Oh, it was a frosted white ghost. These were heavy, so I think that they were, they were just ceramic heavier. Nice set. I love fall most of all. Me too. Tell me if you're the same. Ooh, Gargoyle, $6.99. Now, I know this company, this tag, Pacific, we actually buy a lot of statuary from them, and they are not cheap. I think this guy will work out fine in my magical store, and I'm going to take him and flip my money on that for sure. Then I saw the gorgeous egg. All right. So I looked this guy up, and it was a vintage Avon egg. Now, do you see the crack? I saw it at the very end, and I put it back. Next up, we have this beautiful moon glow. It's a vintage Fenton piece. Guys, anything called moon glow, I'm here for it, okay? I'm just saying. Opalescent, beautiful piece. Matt actually found that piece, so he just handed that over to me. So here I am taking said egg, but at the end, I do notice that there is a crack, so I leave it behind. But if you see it, it's a really pretty piece. Now, onward and upward, we find another piece. This is a Matt's Fine. It is UV reactive. We love that. And upon look as well on research, that it is a sought-after piece of vintage glass. So we're going to take it. All right, so you know Colorful Me. I love this. I love art. This is beautiful. Yes, it needs a good dusting. But I took a moment to look her up, and she is what is considered Mexican folk art paper doll. That's what she is. And it's just beautiful. I really feel like, you know, I could give her a good dusting and just make her shine again. And somebody will appreciate the beautiful, just the beautiful piece that she is. Here's an owl that glows, but it's missing its bell. Interesting plate. Maybe that was a dinosaur head. Oh, I like this plate better, though. Wow, look at this gold scroll work. Ooh, $3.99. I think it was yellow. Tags are half off today. That is a beautiful plate. All right, $6.99. So we're taking a look at this piece, and Matt says we should get it, and I agree. Let's bring it. Let's take it. Let's give him a home. This gator needs a home, all right? He is a real gator taxidermy head. So now he's part of the collection. $4.99. I was eyeballing this piece up. I think it's wooden carved. I didn't peel back the tag to see the maker. But I thought it was a really cute piece. Bobblehead. Oh my, guys, $4.99. Yes, to put with my taxidermy gator head. So you know I love these domed, dried arrangements. And I've been stumbling upon so many of them lately. I don't know how, but yeah, I keep finding more and more. Absolutely beautiful. I haven't put them out yet. I think I'm going to launch a collection of those. I think it would be nice because I have gathered quite a few. That's a fun piece. Bunny with a flower. Tell me if you love those dried arrangements as well. I'm very much a dried flower lover. If you give me flowers, I always say, like, you know, some people will throw out flowers when they die. No, me, I will use them in a vase. Then I will, when they're wilted, I will take them out, turn them upside down. I will tie them and hang them on my wall. So I have tons of just flowers around the shop on the walls. I think it's beautiful. $4.99. This was another gorgeous piece. You know, I had to have it, a vintage piece. I can't remember what the maker of it was. I did look it up real fast, and it is definitely something that can fetch a few bucks, and I think it's gorgeous. So we're going to take it. That's an easy flip. as a reseller, we're just going to dust it off. But it's got a little spoon, a little like nook of carve out there on the lid so you can put your spoon into your sugar dish. Butterfly. Bag of owls. Okay. Yeah, you guys all look in great shape. $4.99 divided by 3. Yes. Yeah, okay. Add you to my owl section. We do have a lot of owl lovers in the house. Some people are either scared of them or okay with them. What side of the fence do you fall on? That was an interesting tube vase. Oh, I like this. This is a shell. But it's got like this rub on it. That's the only reason why I walk away. At first I'm like, is this glue and residue? But no, Matt finds it later too. And I'm like, do you see this part though? And we agreed, yeah, it's just wear and tear. I love this. This is something I can clean up. I did the little test. I think that it can melt away with just a little bit of soap and hot water. It's just got some wax residue, but it's a very beautiful ceramic candle holder. This one I believe I've met before. It's always the rainbow iridescence, the Aurora Borealis look of it, the AB finish, and but it's a little out of my price point for what I'm looking for today. We have got a bag of cups. Oh my gosh, these are the best. Look, candy corn candles. Juicy. Just remember, you have to put the peanut with the candy corn at the same time and put it in your mouth so that you can get the taste of what is like, very similar to a payday bar, like a Snickers type thing. It really does work. You guys told me that. I did the test. And it's true. If it's on the internet, it must be true. That's a cool vase. $2.99. Just checking out the top, and I am identifying a small crack in the top. So as much as I want it, and I don't want the crack to be there, it is what it is. So Matt came across this piece. It does glow, but we agreed to leave it behind. Then he saw this piece, $6.99. Yep, we're going to grab it as well. We've got quite an eclectic haul here today. What's your favorite so far? Because we keep finding more. I think this is a pretty interesting cart, though. Don't hurry, be happy. Life is sweet. Please take a treat. I like that. Oh, I like these painted. I like your fins. We are in the wooden section. To find a rainbow, you must weather a storm. It's a beautiful thought. Find a motivation and inspiration here at Goodwill. Today we're in Ohio at the Ashtabula location. These guys always have their shelves filled with goodies. I love this. So I couldn't tell you how many of these I've bought and sold. I think it was $2.99. Love it. Gonna be mine. Oh, remember this box? Is there a turtle in? No, the turtle is gone. Okay, the turtle was up by the vase in the top shelf. The turtle was in the can. Where are you, Mr. Turtle? Are you here somewhere? Or maybe you found a home. Truth is, I looked for that little turtle. You know him. He's made an appearance different places in my videos and could not find him anywhere. So you know what? Somebody found him. I'm so happy. This was so nice. Matt found this piece. And totally up our alley for what we look for. But it's obviously made wrong. The top doesn't fit onto it. So we got donated, and that's why I love these. Well, let me just be honest. I love tomato soup. I love chicken noodle soup. And I love the little mugs that have the recipes on the front. It's that time of year that I need to pull out all my recipe books. I have quite a vintage cookbook collection. Beautiful. I went to the biggest part of my collection, I think, because I've been collecting cookbooks for a long time, but I went to one auction, and I kid you not, I bought boxes and boxes and boxes and boxes. There were multiple boxes of nothing but cookbooks just from around the world. That obviously, as part of the estate sale, they were up for grabs. Matt went to the restroom. He came back. He couldn't get back to his seat. Who are all these boxes? Who do they belong to? Babe, they belong to us. We now own an entire cookbook collection just like that, with the wave of my cardboard little, you know, auction thing. Yeah. Auction card. Just like that. The auction card is quite amazing. Yeah. Anybody ever enjoy doing the barn auctions or the estate sales where you register, you sit in the audience and you wave your card, you put your card up with your number onto it, and then on the back you write down what you've won, and then at the end of the night you go up and reconcile and pay for all the goods. That's a good time. You'll always, or at least most times, here in Pennsylvania, you'll find a lot of great food on site as well. I do love it when the kitchen is going and they're making their stuffing balls and or pierogies or something like that, but there's always snacks. That's how I used to lure my son to go with me to auctions, is I would say there's snacks. All right, there's snacks. I will give you money and you can go to the back and you can get whatever snacks you want. And that kept him pretty quiet. It was a family outing, right? It was free to get in, to look at other people's stuff, right? That's junk, that's your treasure. See what you wanted. It was a good time by all. And it usually was a few hours in the evening every time. All right, I love that. Oh my, that's so pretty. I like the colors. There's a set of three there. So I've been finding so much good wall stuff. That's an actual canvas. $2.99 for two. So you're talking $1.50 a piece. What does it say? Think happy. Something happy. It's cute. Little cross stitch. There's another set here. They all probably came in at the same time. A good friend knows your stories. A great friend helped you write them. It was so awesome to read your stories yesterday when I was talking about the cabbage versus the lettuce and how sometimes it's just not as clear as you think it would be, especially when you're a kid. Oh my gosh, guys. I chuckled at that. I read them out loud to Matt. We had a good laugh. And then he told me a story as well of something he was sent to the store for when he was a young boy and he didn't know the difference between, right? I guess it happens to a lot of us. House blend coffee. Oh my gosh, guys. Oh, more dried flower stuff. Yes to all of this. Okay, here is somebody who did this. Look, they put wallpaper in the back. It's $5 a piece. It is handmade. You can see right there. These were made in Ohio. I think the date is on them somewhere as well. But somebody did a whole dried flower arrangement. 1980. Tell me that's not gorgeous. Tell me if you also appreciate beautiful things like this. So somebody took a lot of time to do this, and I'm so glad that I was able to rescue them. And I know that I can find somebody who will be so proud and just so happy to put them on their wall. And then I found this in the book section. Okay, there was two books, actually. This is a vintage glass tableware identification book. Yeah, pretty amazing. I'm going to take a browse through these, and then I'm also going to put them up for sale. But it's also Fostoria tableware. So yeah, to find these back to back, these old books, right? Like, you know, once they go out of print, if you don't find the actual book again. So I feel like this was a great treasure. So I'm going to educate myself, take a browse through, and then put them up for sale. Yeah. Would you have grabbed them too?